It still fascinates me.
The incredible beauty of the universe.
I call it a marathon and not a sprint.
We never wanted to be in second place.
Whatever I wanted to do, I felt that I could do it.
I think there's going to be the world as it was known before genomics and the world after. Part of my success is having a certain naivete about what's involved and being able to see the bigger picture and believe in it.
Craig Venter was a central player in the 20th century's scientific journey of a lifetime, mapping the human genome. His approach to science was unconventional to some, but intriguing to others.
Ham Smith and I met each other at a meeting, and we became good friends after that. So it was happenstance in the sense that that's how we ended up doing Haemophilus.
The Haemophilus influenza bacteria was the first genome that Smith and Venter mapped using Venter's shotgun method.
When we published that paper in Science in 1995, I said this is the technique that we will use in a few years to sequence the human genome. The challenge and the problem was, how do you read 6 billion letters of genetic code when all you can do is read 500 letters at a time?
Shotgun sequencing was a bold idea, where the billions of letters of the human genome would shatter into smaller 1,000-letter strands.
So the big breakthroughs were actually in the computational side.
More robust computers enabled Venter to reassemble these bits in his lab at Celera Genomics.
What does one do after sequencing the human genome? What are some of the biggest problems facing humanity that my background in science, the tools that we had, could maybe shed some light on? Surviving a year in Vietnam, one of my dreams was to sail around the world. One of my passions is sailing, and so we decided to try and apply these same shotgun sequencing techniques to the oceans just to see who was there.
In Venter's first sample, he discovered as many as 40,000 new species in 200 liters of seawater. He continues his nautical journey, where over 19 million genes have been discovered in Venter's on-sea laboratory and then studied at the Venter Institute.
I spend the absolute majority of my time looking forward, very little time looking back.